Hello, everybody. It's Friday, the last show in the first week of Countdown in 2023, and our first champion of champions in five whole years. The Standard this week has been magnificent, and all Rachel with the brilliant Richard Osman in Dictionary Corner. And he casually dropped in yesterday that his brother is more talented than he is, because, of course, his brother is the bass player, Matt Osman, with Suede. Is your brother got a claim to fame that when people go, oh, you're Rachel Riley, your brother can go, well, hold on a second?
Well, my brother has been on Countdown as well. He once got a conundrum that the contestants didn't get, won himself a mug, and has a screenshot of himself next to the word, his winning word, which was simpleton. Congratulations, Alex Riley, simpleton.
Well, let's formally introduce Dictionary Corner at Susie Dent and the first of three beards on the show today, the brilliant Richard Osman. So who have we got today? Well, it's Tom Stevenson. Nice to meet you for the first time.
I know.
Who are you and where do you come from?
I'm 21. I come from Burford in Shropshire and I'm a student.
Mate, I feel like you and I've seen you more times than my friends over the last 6 months or so. But what a whirlwind for you. You know, just for people that don't know, 165 rounds. He's only lost one. That was in the final of the last series. And that was because Ed Byrne got a 9, right? That's what we're talking about. Well, this will be the only time you've got no poids today, I'm sure of that.
Fingers crossed.
You're going up against another familiar face to me, so I'm a bit, my heart's ripped in two today. Really, it's going to be emotional. Adam Latchford is back. He won Series 83 of Countdown. How are you, mate?
Yeah, I'm doing well. It's good to see you again.
So what's new with you? Because it's been quite some time. You know, in these turbulent times, I believe you're a homeowner now.
I am, yeah. I've just purchased my first property. It went through finally before all the mortgage rates went up, so... Oh. My timing is impeccable, as always. That's my biggest achievement outside of Countdown.
I was going to say, getting a house is nothing and winning Champion of Champions, let me tell you, sir.
Well, winning Champion of Champions is a far cry from right this moment. I've got one of the best players of all time next to me, so...
Let's find out what happens today. Tom and Adam, everyone. Mr. Stevenson, you know the drill.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi again, Tom.
A vowel, please.
Thank you. Start to today with A.
And a consonant.
T.
And a second.
R.
And a vowel.
I.
A consonant, please.
C.
A consonant.
T.
A vowel.
A.
And another vowel.
I.
Ooh, and I'll go for a consonant, please.
Lastly, N.
At home, man in the studio, let's play Countdown. Time, Tom.
I'll play a safe 6.
And Adam.
I will try a 7.
The 6 is, Tom?
Attain,
that's definitely safe. What is the 7 you're trying?
Try a Titanic.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Titanic, as in something is Titanic. And that's surely not capitalised.
It's not in the sense of being of exceptional strength or power.
Wow,
very good.
That is a Titanic start to today's show. Anything else in Dictionary Corner?
No, we had Titanic, we had it intact, and also Trisha is there.
That's not going to be in the dictionary.
No, yeah, but it was nice to see it there. If you were sitting at home and you're called Trisha, you would have seen your name in there, and for no one to mention it, I think would be remiss.
Well, you didn't mention Ant, but OK. Let's get more letters. Adam, it's on you.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Adam.
Please, can we start with a consonant?
We can indeed start with L.
And a consonant?
N.
And a third?
T.
And a fourth.
W.
A vowel, please.
A.
And a second.
E.
And a third.
I.
A fourth.
A.
And we'll finish with a vowel, please.
Finish with I.
30 seconds.
Thank you.
Time's up. Adam?
I'm stuck on six.
And Tom?
I'll go for a six as well.
OK, what have you got there, Adam?
Entail.
Entail. And Tom?
Off the block.
Yeah, same word. Just before Richard tells us what he has, I just want to say hello to Al, Talia and Walt. What have you got?
Can't believe you missed out Tina. we only got Entail as well.
Fantastic. Tom has six. Adam has 13. 10 points up for grabs. Our first numbers round of this champion of champions, last 16 tie. And Tom, you're picking them, my friend.
Four from the top.
The first time you've ever been behind. And you don't want to be in this position for too long. Four large. Let's see if this changes things. Two little ones, three and seven. And the big four, 50, 100, 25 and 75. And the target to start, 311.
311. Numbers up. One, Tom.
I didn't get it. I got 310.
One away. Adam.
311.
Let's hear it.
100 plus 3.
100 plus 3, 103.
Times by 75.
Times by 75 is 7,725.
Add the 50.
Add the 50. 7,775.
And divide it by 25.
And divide it by 25. And you get 300 and... 11.
Wow. I love the fact Tom just went...
I'm not kicking myself over that one.
Brilliant stuff. 23-6, very early on in the show. But Richard Osman, not only quiz show royalty, but also a good friend and a huge Countdown fan.
Yes.
So I'd like to invite you, but you don't have to say yes, because I think we'd all like to say it. Would you like to host 5 minutes?
Yes.
For reals?
For reals. Totes?
Yeah.
Good. I just
really?
Think, yeah, absolutely. I'd love to see you do it. I'm sure everyone else would love to see you do
Great.
It.
Great.
OK, well, I'll give you the tea time teaser. Richard will pick up at the other side of the break. Ref rants. Ref rants. Will the football player make a move to Manhattan? Will the football player make a move to Manhattan?
Welcome back to Countdown. My name's Richard Osman. I am the new host. Your tea time teaser. Will the football player make a move to Manhattan? Reference becomes transfer. Gentlemen, what a champion of champions we are having. Adam, your turn to choose some letters.
Thank you, Richard. Rachel, please can I start with a consonant?
You can indeed. X.
And another?
R.
A third?
L.
A vowel, please.
U.
And another.
I.
And another.
O.
And a fourth.
E.
A consonant, please.
S.
And we'll finish with a vowel, please.
Finish with O.
And here's your 30 seconds. Is up, Adam. What do you have?
I'll stick with a seven.
Stick with a seven, Tom?
Yeah, the safe seven.
Seven as well. Adam, what's your seven?
Lousier.
Lousier, Tom.
Yeah, lousier as well.
Lousier as well. 7 points each. I'm assuming that's all right, Susie.
Yeah. It's totally
Dictionary funny. Corner, Tiny Colin.
I'll level with you. This chair's a lot lower than it used to be. Mm. But I didn't want to change it because it's.
and this one's a lot higher. And also, you got a little booster pad, Carl, didn't you?
Well, lousier counts, but you remember earlier in the week we had Mariners, which is a baseball team. So we had the Seattle Mariners. Well, this time we got the Baltimore Orioles. So you could add Orioles as well.
Lovely. Also, of course, in there is Louise. Tom, some letters from you, please.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Tom. T.
And a second.
Y.
And a third.
N.
A fourth, please.
V.
A fifth.
W.
And a sixth.
S.
And then a vowel.
A.
A vowel.
E.
And another vowel, please.
And I.
And your 30 seconds start now.
How many, Tom?
Seven.
And Adam?
I'll stick with a seven.
OK, what's your word, Tom?
Natives.
And Adam?
Yeah, same word.
I believe natives as well. Good for seven. By the way, both of you, don't look so disappointed and back. It's unbelievable. That's all it took. One round. You feel like you had something else there. What was it?
I think yawniest.
Oh.
Yawniest is in the dictionary. Ooh. Yeah, producing a lot of yawning.
A nice one.
Yeah,
but Richard, with a 17-point lead, I suppose you would tactically just air slightly.
Yeah, you've got to, haven't you? That was fun hosting for a little bit.
Really good.
And it's very, very nerve-wracking, but thank you. I see written down in front of me, so I must have written it vainest.
Oh, very good word. Yeah, thank very you. Good indeed.
Thank you. It doesn't look like it's in my handwriting. That's so weird.
I left you that little present.
Thank you.
Right, let's get our next round, which is back to the numbers. And Adam, you're picking.
We're going to have too large and be quite dull, Rachel, I'm afraid.
Well, you never know what can happen with the numbers, but you're hoping for dull anyway. Let's see, Adam. The four little ones. 4, 2, 1, 6, big 225 and 100. And the target, probably dull, 254.
254, numbers up. Adam.
Yeah, 254.
Yeah, Tom.
Yeah, 254.
Of course it is. Adam, off you go.
6 minus 1.
6 minus 1 is 5.
Times 2.
10.
Times 25.
250.
Add 4.
Yeah.
Yeah, lots of ways for this one. That is one of them.
Yeah, there are, Tom. What about you?
100 plus 25.
Yeah. 125.
Multiply by 2.
250.
And add the 4 on.
Yep, that's not going to close any gaps around here.
Yeah. Right, listen, Richard, you've been entertaining us all week, but this is our chance to ask you questions on the Friday. Susie, I think, will be keeping it short with her laryngitis, but what have you got?
It's such a cliché question, so I apologise in advance, but when you start writing, do you know exactly what's going to happen already?
No, I don't. Sometimes I do, but sometimes it takes you by surprise because the characters, the book's about characters, and they take you by surprise. If it takes me by surprise, I hope it takes readers by surprise as well. Here's one secret about crime fiction. Sometimes you can change the murderer, and people go, don't you have to unravel everything?
Oh, wow.
But the thing is, in a good crime book, everybody is a suspect all the way through. So you can change the murderer, and actually you only change a couple of little things. That's a little reverse engineering secret.
I interviewed Ian Rankin recently, of course, who created Rebus, and he said the same thing. He said, I don't know where I'm going when I start.
Yeah, he really doesn't. He absolutely, I think I have more of a plan than Ian Rankin, but, you know, he's a genius. So.
Yeah, brilliant. Rachel.
Well, you're pretty recognisable
in this country for sure. But what about when you go abroad? Do people know you overseas?
Yeah, they started to. That was a nice thing. We saw, because over here, I thought, oh, I hope people are not just buying this because I'm on telly. Yeah. But we started selling it abroad. So I think we're in 60 countries now.
Wow.
And there's things like, you know, there's Chinese versions and there's Japanese versions and Brazilian and stuff. My daughter speaks Chinese and she's reading the Chinese version. And she said, it's absolutely brilliant. She said, every single page, there's so many footnotes explaining to people what Sainsbury's Taste of the Difference and Lutz and Oliver Bonus and even like Ashford International, just explaining to people what those things are. The Americans, so the British and the American people are the only people who are allowed any input at all. And the Americans, they get it through and just check for anything that doesn't make sense to them. And in the very first book, funnily enough, they said, no, I think we pretty much get all the references. They said, there's one thing we don't get. There's one thing we think we missed a little bit of the plot. There's a character called Ron. And he goes, at one point you say that Ron goes for a slash in the woods. We don't understand. Is he stabbing someone? I had to explain that having a slash in England is slightly different. So it's, occasionally you get the odd mistranslation error, even with the Americans.
I'm going to ask you a question that's unfair.
Oh, lovely.
An evil genie appears.
Yeah.
And says, Richard Osman, I have the power to wipe out history. And I'm going to wipe out from history and your history pointless our House of Games. Which one do you keep?
Well, I mean, it feels like a genie would have better things to do, but to wipe out one of them. It's interesting that, because I love making House of Games. And I love making Pointless and working with Xander. I think because I met my wife on House of Games.
Yeah,
I'd have to get rid of Pointless because otherwise I wouldn't have married her. But I owe so much to Pointless. It's so much fun I had on it, and it will always remain very dear to my heart. So I'm hoping that genie isn't backstage now, ready to do it.
Right, Adam, our underdog, is on 47. He thrives being that. Tom's on 30. So close. Let's get more letters from you, Mr. Stevenson.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Tom. U.
And a second.
E.
And another.
O.
A consonant.
T.
And another.
P.
And another.
D.
A fourth, please.
C.
A fifth.
T.
And I shall go for a final consonant, please.
A final. N.
Start the clock. Time, gentlemen, please. Tom.
I think I'm going to have to try an eight.
He's on the ropes. Adam.
I might have to try the same eight, maybe.
OK,
maybe.
Tom.
Unpotted.
Unpotted. And Adam.
Yeah, I might be up the garden path.
Don't worry.
Unpotted.
Fine.
You've done an Osman. You found a six-letter word. You put the UN at the start of it. So if you hadn't said it, Osman would have.
I do have it, yeah.
But Susie, you have the final word.
Yeah, to unpot a seedling or a young plant is simply to remove it from a pot.
Fantastic. Adam, more letters. Let's keep it rolling.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Adam. P.
And a second.
G.
And a third.
R.
A fourth.
B.
A vowel, please.
I.
And a second.
O.
A third.
U.
A fourth.
E.
And we'll finish with a vowel, please.
Finish with A.
Here we go. Adam.
Seven.
Tom.
Seven as well.
You've gone with the sevens. OK, Adam.
Groupie. Also a groupie.
Good. Two groupies.
Well, three groupies. I got a groupie, but Susie said pirogue. Pirogue?
Pirogue, yeah, P-I-R-O-G-U-E, is a long, narrow canoe made from a single tree trunk.
Good. Right, let's get numbers, and it's you, Tom.
Three large, please, Rachel.
Three large? Was you set on three large there?
Possibly, who knows?
Bit of gambling, right? It could make all the difference. Three large, three little. You need these 10 points. The little ones. 1, 3, 6. The big ones. 25, 150. And the target, 821.
821, numbers up. Shaking of heads. 821, Tom.
822.
One away, Adam.
822.
Oh my goodness me. Tom, off you go.
50 times 6 is 300.
300.
Take away the 1.
299.
And then multiply it by 3.
897.
And then 100 minus 25, 75.
Yep.
And take that off.
For 1 above. 822.
Adam.
Completely different. 100 plus 50.
100. Plus 50.
And times by 6.
150 by 6 is 900.
25 plus 1.
25 plus 1.
Times by 3.
Times 3, 78.
And then take that off.
Same result.
OK, 7 points each. Is that as good as it gets?
It's not, but you'll have to leave it with me.
Right. Good time to do just that as we take our second break of the day on this Champion of Champions countdown. And it's Dense Pig. Dense Pig, a favourite pastime of the over 70s. A favourite pastime of the over 70s. Welcome back. Dense Pig becomes speeding, a favourite pastime of the over 70s. Let's race back to Rachel because you've worked out the numbers.
Yeah, I can't believe these boys missed this. They're really going to kick themselves. If you say 50 times by 100 for 5,000, 3 times 25 is 75. Take that away for 4,925. Add the 1 for 4,926 and divide it by 6.
Oh, for goodness sake. We're clapping along. Could be wrong.
Yeah, that's true.
No way of knowing.
Yeah.
No, that. Right, back to the game. Adam, business end of this, final part of this Champion of Champions, and you've got a lead of 17, and it's your letters.
I'll start with a consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Adam. T.
And a second.
N.
A third.
L.
A fourth.
S.
A fifth.
G.
A vowel.
E.
And another.
I.
And another.
A.
And we will finish with a consonant, please.
Finish with...
Ooh.
S.
Start that clock.
Thank you.
Time is up. Adam?
9.
And Tom?
I'm going to have to go with a 9.
OK, Adam, what's yours?
Teaslings.
And Tom?
Slangiest.
OK, I'm going to start with teasling. Teasel is in as a prickly plant, but it is not there as a verb, so there's no teasling, I'm afraid.
So, Adam's 9 will not count.
No.
So if Tom's does, it completely changes the face of this game.
And it does, because slangiest is in the dictionary.
And just like that, Tom is in the lead by one single point. Tom, 9 more letters.
Let's go for a consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Tom. L.
And a second.
R.
And a third.
P.
And a vowel, please.
E.
And another.
U.
And another.
E.
A consonant.
S.
A consonant.
L.
And another consonant, please.
Lastly, D.
Countdown. It's like another big round, this, doesn't it, Tom?
Go for an 8.
And Adam?
8.
OK, the 8s are, Tom?
Preludes.
Preludes. And is that the prelude to the same word?
It's not. I'm more repulsed.
What a great word to find after you've been gobbed by a 9. Repulsed. Fantastic. 2 wonderful 8s.
Yep, same. Yeah. Repulsed and preludes is what, is what we had here.
And we usually have origins of words here. I don't want to push it too far. It's almost good that Susie has laryngitis. I just want to get the next round in.
That's... I mean, listen, it has its upsides.
For yourself.
Yeah, particularly for Susie, who's having such an easy week.
Let's do it then, Adam. More letters.
A consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Adam. Z.
And a vowel.
O.
And a vowel.
E.
And a vowel.
O.
And a consonant, please.
B.
And a vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
N.
And a consonant.
T.
And a vowel, please.
Lastly, E.
OK, let's do it. That's time up. Adam?
7.
Tom?
I'll have to risk a 7 then.
OK. Adam, what's your 7?
O's an 8.
O's an 8. And Tom? Well, Susie, I can't believe there's a 7 there.
Well, there is something longer there, but it's not O's an 8, I'm afraid. That is not in the dictionary. Sorry, boys.
Ruled out. No points for both of you, but something longer.
Yeah, Susie pushed a word over to me which has 8 letters and is...
Benzoate.
Benzoate?
Yes.
No idea, come on.
It's a derivative of benzoic acid, which is used as a food preservative, essentially.
You know, benzoate.
Benzoate. Oh, I put it in all my dishes. Yeah. Right. Well, these two serving up a treat. 1 point in it still between Tom and Adam, and we know what that means, the crucial countdown conundrum, but we've counted our chickens before, so let's not do it. One more letters round, and it is the history maker, Tom Stevenson.
A vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Tom. O.
And another.
E.
Consonant, please.
J.
And another.
H.
And another.
S.
Consonant.
T.
And another.
R.
A vowel, please.
O.
And another consonant, please.
Lastly, F.
Let's play countdown. Thank you.
7.
Adam?
I'm going to gamble an 8.
OK. Tom, what's the 7?
Footers.
And Adam, what's the gamble?
4 shots.
It's not in, I'm afraid, Adam. I'm sorry.
Now, actually, it's a very clever gamble, Richard, because as long as he navigates the numbers, then he's exactly. It's still going to be a crucial countdown conundrum. So, again, this is the brilliant strategy that's underrated in countdown.
Games within games within games, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, we had a Guy Ritchie movie over here with Hooters and Shooter.
Yeah. 2 7s that we allow. So, even though that's opened it up to an 8-point gap, we're still in crucial conundrum territory. But that depends, Adam, on what happens in our last numbers round.
We are going to try and get to a crucial, Rachel, with a 2 large.
Oh. 2 large. Wow, you're banking everything on that conundrum. You're obviously confident in conundrums.
We'll see.
Even at this elite level. Right, final numbers of the day, of the week even. 5, 7, 5, 8, 125. And the target, 617.
617. Last numbers. Adam?
617.
Tom?
617.
Off you go, Adam.
25 times 5 times 5.
25 by 5 by 5, 625.
Take 8.
I like the contrasting styles of you 2 seconds in, pen down, Tom checking it for the whole 30 seconds.
Tom actually has a habit of, even if he's got a 9, 25 seconds in, he's going... you make me so nervous. Tom, let's see. Do you
very similar in principle. 100 plus 25 times by the 5.
Again, 625.
And then I took the 8 off.
Good luck, you two. Well
Thank
done.
Thank you very much.
So here we go. Tom has got 95. Adam has got 87. Adam Latchford is unbeaten in countdown history. Tom Stevenson is unbeaten in countdown history. Fingers on buzzers, because the O must go. Let's reveal this crucial countdown conundrum. It's Adam.
Broquette.
Let's take a look. Yes! Adam Latchford makes history by beating the history maker. What a game.
I know.
What a game. I'm coming to you, Tom, because even in defeat, you've always been the most magnanimous winner. And in defeat, you look like the most gracious loser.
Well, to be quite honest, I'm happy that Adam won that game because I thought he played better than what I did. But I had a great time. And, I think it made for great television, this particular game.
Right. How did you feel when he pulled the 9 out? Because I think the most impressive thing of the whole show was you staying focused on the very next round after that.
It hurt me because he overtook it, and I was thinking about Yorniest earlier, which I bottled, and I would have stayed ahead with that. So I just had to compose myself and rethink through. But thankfully, there's enough rounds in Game Countdown there. You can keep your focus.
I don't want to say it, but I do think that's my favourite week of Countdown ever, and I'm so glad you were here for it as well, Richard.
I mean, it's been absolutely extraordinary. I couldn't have picked a better week other than Susie's voice. and the week has got better and better and closer, and that was an incredible finish to an incredible game. I mean, they're just brilliant. It's honestly a pleasure and a joy and an honour just to watch you play, so thank you.
Well, listen, hopefully Countdown will have you in that corner again. Which
Love to.
Great. You rest up at the weekend.
I will.
All right. Usually, Rachel, I hate this time, but actually, I need the rest.
even though we've not had much to do this week, because they're doing all the work for us, but 5 potential Champion of Champions winners and 6 more, you've something to say about it next week.
Absolutely, and that'll be Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, then Thursday, Friday, straight into the quarterfinals. The week after that, I can't think about or I'll hyperventilate. So that's all for now. We'll see you Monday. Rachel, Susie and I will be here. You can count on us.
You can contact the programme by email at countdown@channel4.com or write to us at countdownleeds_LS3 1JS. You can also find our webpage at channel4.com/countdown.